we're going to provide a very short introduction into how to use the Amina database as a logged in user to find data at specific sites that you're looking for. So this is the homepage of the Amina database, the above URL. Now I'm currently logged in as myself. Hello, I'm Michael Fredley. But if you weren't logged in, there would be a login option here that you would click on, and to log out, click on log out here. And hopefully, as long as you're a registered user, you'll have your login details ready. You can also change the language of the database from English currently to Arabic. The database hasn't been fully translated yet into Arabic. A large majority of the terms, particularly the drop-down terminology, is changed. To click back to English, changing it. Now along the top of the screen, we have a number of options. Home, which will bring you back to this screen, the home page. There is a textual and map search option. There is a map view and a resource manager, which is at which point you will create new records. But in this tutorial, we'll just be talking about finding existing data. There's also the RDM, which is about the management of the database, which is not of concern as part of this tutorial. So if we go first to the map view, this will take us to a satellite mapped overview of the region. And because of the amount of data in the database, it'll take a moment to load. These purple groups of records are information records, and the yellow records are the actual heritage resource E27s. I mean, they're grouped in large numbers at the moment, but as we zoom in and we scroll back across, they start to break down into smaller numbers until eventually ending as these small individual pins. If we click on one, it gives us the basic details of the site. It's a mean, a name, number. You can either choose to view report, as so, which will open in a new tab. And again, this will give you the basic report details of the site. You can also click down at this lower level for any related resources attached to this record, of which there are currently none. To get full editorial right to this record, either click Edit in the top right, or else, if we return back to our last page, you can click straight through to edit at this stage. So that is one way of finding your record if you know where it is exactly on a map. We see they start to bunch up again as different sites. So we can also choose to add in either a place name, as long as it's held within the glossary, or Latin long details here to take to a specific location. Should also mention at this stage, we can also use the base map options to change the base map. And we can turn off particular overlays. Now, another way of finding specific sites or to search particular types of sites is via the search option, which takes you to a textual search. Here we can search on particular terms, and also in some cases, if there are a resource has a resource name, we might be able to find particular resources. For instance, Cyrene, which comes up a lot in these tutorials. So we have both Cyrene as a name, but also the different designated components of Cyrene. Another way we can look is via particular search terms. For instance, we can search via Tunisia, both just as a either click return now for just a textual search on Tunisia, or records that are registered as being part of the modern country of territory of Tunisia, of which there are only 366 records currently in the database. If we go to a country that we currently have more data in the database, for instance, Yemen, we can add additional search terms to this to break down, because we currently, once the data is loaded, we'll see that there are over 37,000 records in the database. Sometimes the database can work quite slowly, particularly when you're working with a large amount of data. And on top of this, we can add another search term For instance, of those 37,000 sites, which are considered destroyed, of which there are 25. And we can choose by clicking this icon on the right to see them displayed on a map. And then, just as with the map view before, we can click on a particular site. It gives us the basic information. We can choose the view of the report. In this case, we can't go straight into the edit page. We have to choose view report, and then we can choose to edit if necessary. We can close both those two tabs. And you can add a number of additional terms to find the specific site you need to find. You can also use the various codes that we use. So, for instance, this grid currently only has one site in. Or you can add in the whole code name if you have it available. So there are a number of different ways of finding your records and reaching the edit stage as part of the Amina database.